We have already heard about horizontal coordinate systems and the equatorial coordinate system. Today, we will discuss other two systems which are frequently used for astronomical purposes. One is the ecliptic coordinate system and the other one is the galactic coordinate system. So, what are these? If you look at the plane of ecliptic, that is the mean Earth's plane, orbital plane around the Sun, we realize that almost all planets have orbits in this similar planes, almost same plane. You can see here, for example, this dashed line is the ecliptic, that is Earth's orbital plane, and all the planets, they are always very close to this plane. There's, sometimes they can, in extreme cases, they can be slightly off. Even Moon is nearly in the same plane, slightly off sometimes. Quantify that. Among the planets, Mercury's orbital inclination with respect to Earth's orbital plane is 7 degrees, and all the planets are smaller than that. So, like Venus is 3 degrees, Mars is 1.8 degrees, Jupiter 1.3 degrees, the fairly small numbers. You can see others as well. As a result of that, if you view everything in the plane of ecliptic, it will appear as if everybody is going in almost same plane. And if you can work in a system where ecliptic is your reference, then that will make your calculations a lot easier. So what we do, we define coordinates called ecliptic latitude and ecliptic longitude with ecliptic as a reference. In arithmetic system, if you remember, we had taken equator as our reference. So we had a line, one reference circle was our equator, and second reference longitude, we had taken the arc which passed through the north celestial pole, south celestial pole, and it cut equator at the vernal equinox point. Now here, we will take ecliptic as our reference, which is the green circle. We will take the arc which passes through north ecliptic pole, south ecliptic pole, and cuts ecliptic at same vernal equinox point. And we define our coordinates with those reference. Here, the black circle is the equator. Obviously, you know that this is inclined by 23.5 degrees, which is fixed to ecliptic. So, position of north celestial pole is also 23.5 degrees away from north ecliptic pole. Now, in this system, it is just like the arithmetic system. One coordinate, we draw circles parallel to ecliptic. Other coordinates, we draw arcs which are perpendicular to ecliptic. So, ecliptic latitude is like our Earth latitude, north or south of ecliptic, going from minus 90 at south to plus 90. And ecliptic longitude, just like Earth longitude, so going from vernal equinox point to eastwards, that is the region where ecliptic goes above equator and make a full circle 0 to 360. Ecliptic longitude is denoted by lambda and ecliptic latitude is denoted by beta. Now, advantage of this system is if you use this system, then for solar system objects, essentially since beta is almost 0 for all the planets and moon and most of the asteroids, we can work essentially with single coordinate as an approximation by assuming beta is 0 and do calculations that way. We already get answer which is fairly close to the actual answer. The second advantage is you know that because of Earth's precision, the vernal equinox point keeps changing. But vernal equinox point's position, as it changes, Earth's axis direction will change. If Earth's axis direction changes, equator's direction changes. But ecliptic direction doesn't change, is not affected by precision. So the location of this point will change, but that change, that turning of the vernal equinox point will be just linear on the ecliptic. So the change in ecliptic longitude because of one liquid of precision, Earth precision, will be just linear, and there will be no change in ecliptic latitude. So for calculations which involve precision, ecliptic is a very convenient system. Now going from ecliptic system to galactic system, if we want to measure motions of stars in our galaxy or in our Milky Way, it's very convenient to think of the average plane, or what we call as mid plane of the galaxy, and think of system in that. Now, thing is, if you take this plane of the galaxy, major plane, solar system is highly inclined, more than 60 degrees inclined to this plane. So, any calculation which you do with either ecliptic system or equatorial system, it is going to be lot more difficult to trace motions of stars going around the center of Milky Way. So, for that, we have a new system, what is the galactic coordinates. In that, what we do, in our coordinate system, Sun is at the center of the system. And from Sun, we point towards the center of the galaxy, center of the Milky Way, and that is the direction of our zero galactic longitude, which is denoted by symbol small l. And then towards east, the same increasing direction as the increasing direction of ecliptic longitude or increasing direction of RA, the same direction, we keep increasing the galactic longitude from 0 to 360. Now, for the galactic latitude, which is denoted by symbol B, what we do is that half of the sky, that is equator, celestial equator divides the sky in two halves, the north of equator and south of equator. Now, there is one pole, that is, if you draw a line perpendicular to the mid plane, this will give you two galactic poles, north galactic poles, south galactic poles. One of these poles will be north of Earth's equator, as we see from Earth, other one will be south of Earth's equator. The one which is north of Earth's equator, we call it north galactic pole. The one which is south of Earth's equator, we call it south galactic pole. For galaxy, it is not, there is no north and south. It is our convenience, we call one as north, one as south. Now, so same thing is shown as in diagonal here. If you point to north galactic pole, and from north galactic pole, you draw an arc, that will give you what is the galactic latitude. From middle plane of the galaxy, this galactic plane, you measure the galactic latitude, and from the center of the galaxy till this longitude, that angle will give you galactic longitude, which is L. If you look at the sky, we are always used to seeing sky maps which are in equatorial coordinates, or sometimes in we see sky for different days and different locations in horizontal coordinates. But if you see sky in galactic coordinates, where the central line is a galactic plane, the sky looks a bit different. The constellations which we are used to see in the middle part, they go on the sides. Constellations which we are used to see in the side parts, they come to the middle. For example, the north galactic pole is in Cuca-Berenices, which is actually quite close to equator. And similarly, south galactic pole is in Sculpture. The galaxy's center is, as you know, is in Sagittarius, and anticenter is the point opposed to that is in Oregon. So if you exactly see 1 degree away, so somewhere on the edge here you will find Oregon. So these four coordinates, the two which we saw in the previous video and these two, are the ones in which like almost all the calculations for astronomical purposes are done. Thank you.